So the other day I found myself eating broccoli and liking it. I had to stop and wonder, where did I go wrong in life? What happened to my taste buds? Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Right now, there are thousands of taste buds on your tongue. Some estimates say as many as 10,000. And no, you don't have specific areas on your tongue for certain flavors. The taste buds are all kind of mixed together. When you look at your tongue, you're seeing little bumps, which are little clumps of taste buds, which contain 50 to 100 taste cells, kind of like a head of broccoli. One study got up close and personal with these minuscule mysteries. Taste buds look kind of like little bulbs or little flowers, with receptor cells looking like the petals surrounded by blood cells, which in turn is surrounded by collagen. These taste cells take chemical signals from the food you eat and send it to taste centers in your brain. Seriously, there's a place in your brain just for tasting called the gustatory cortex. Speaking of broccoli though, like when I was really little, I hated it. Hated it. Have my taste buds changed as I grew up? Well, yeah, kind of. It's no secret kids like sweet things, but maybe that's biology. One study published in the journal Physiology Behavior found that growing bones release hormones that cause children to crave the sweets. That way, their growing body gets the energy it needs. The researchers also found that in people whose bones stopped growing, they had less of those hormones. So maybe that's why adults find overly sweet things sickening and prefer other flavors, like delicious bitter broccoli. Why is it so good? As for your actual taste buds, well, the cells in your taste buds don't last for long. They change all the time. The average lifespan for a cell is anywhere from a few days to a month. But a lot of things can affect your sense of taste, from temperature to altitude to music. That gustatory cortex I mentioned takes in information from a lot of different sources from your other senses. And memory affects taste too. There's a thing called conditioned taste aversion, or CTA. Most of us have experienced this. For example, my sister hates buffalo chicken dip. Hates it, because a few years ago, she ate it around the same time she got a nasty stomach flu. So now a circuit in her amygdala is like, girl, you do not want to eat that dip, you will get sick. And a study published in the Journal of Neuroscience found that that negative association is particularly strong if you're in the same place as that bad experience. Now, not to get all evolutionary psychology on you, but that makes a certain amount of sense. If our ancestors wandering about the savanna came across some bad berries, they'd be more likely to survive if their brain associated that place and berry with throwing up or something like that, so they wouldn't eat it again. But on the other hand, good experiences might make food taste better. So if you want your kid to, one day eat vegetables, make it fun, like putting broccoli on top of mashed potato mountain so it looks like a little landscape. Okay, yeah, you know what? I don't think you can make vegetables fun. So no, that whole taste buds changing every 7 years thing isn't true. Your taste buds are changing all the time. And other things affect your taste, like music. To learn more about how music can make you taste things differently, check out this great video from our friends over at Brit Lab. It blew my mind. Go watch it. I really recommend it.
So one of the things he looked at was how to make a crisp taste crunchier. And he discovered that as you bite into a crisp, if you play high frequency music, it makes it taste a lot crunchier.
All right guys, have your tastes changed in your life? Like, I used to love sugary drinks, now I love dark and bitter coffee. What about you? Tell us your thoughts in the comments down below. While you're there, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.